you.
Check 1-2. 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 Check 1-2.
Harper Bell's number 14,
Check 1-2. Check 1-2.
Thank you. dunk. Here comes the dunk.
Now he beat me.
I'm
good. Oh, we're finally on the air here. We got one mic working. 20-18 Stoughton. 8:26 left first half. Yep. Janesville got it. Inside three. No good. Anderson rebound. Here comes Stoughton. Hutcherson. Three ball. Hobson. Rimming no. Tipped out of bounds. Gonna go down to Janesville. Under 8 minutes left, first half.
Can you guys hear me?
Yep.
You guys can?
Yes.
I
got one mic working, one headset. He's shooting two. First one's good. 21-8, Stoughton. Second one's good. 22-8, Stoughton. 7:40 left, first half. Janesville bringing it up. Seven 30 left, first half. Oh, three ball. Rimming no. Hutcherson rebound. Here comes Stoughton. They're running. Anderson for three. Rimming no. Tipped out of bounds. That's gonna go down to Janesville. Janesville Parker trailing 22-8. 7:12 left, first half. Janesville Parker's been settling for a lot of three-pointers. Now they try to get it inside, tipped away. Battle for it. Janesville keeps it. Takes a three. Good defense, Stoughton. Mid-range shot, looked like he might have been fouled, and he was. A foul's gonna go on number four, Drew Anderson.
Shamar Curry, number 30 to the line.
First one's up, no good. Checking in for the first time is 24.
Ooh, number 24, Ethan Scavlin, gonna get a little time here.
I'm clear. Just keep going. Nine. 6:30 left, first half. Hutcherson all the way, rimming no. Off the backboard, no good. Here comes Parker.
Stoughton definitely in control here, up 22-9.
Janesville, mid-range shot. That's gonna be a way short. Tipped and it comes out to Hobson. Hobson over to Anderson, shoots a three. Back iron, no good. Reese Sproul, nice rebound, go up strong, buddy. There you go. 24-9, Stoughton. Nice rebound by, rebound and put in by the sophomore, Sproul. Long three for Parker. No good. And a foul.
It's going to be a foul on number 12, Robert DeLong.
Timeout on the floor. Timeout, Parker. 5:33 left in the first half. 24-9, Stoughton.
Hill hasn't been on the floor. Have they been able to score?
Not very much.
Clearly in control of this game, though, huh, Jay?
Yes, 15-point lead. First game of the year for Stoughton. A little late getting on the air here tonight. Some audio difficulties. Looking at Stoughton's roster tonight, we have starting was Cale McGee, Nathan Hutcherson, Drew Anderson, Adam Hobson.
Up by 13 with 5:33 left in the first half.
And the other starter was, let me see here, Jack Nelson. So the only senior that starts is number 4, Drew Anderson. And Anderson will be at the line, shooting the bonus, 1-1. That's 18 fouls on Parker. First one's good. Second free throw. It's good. 26-9, Stoughton. 5:29 left, first half. Janesville just having a difficult time scoring. In the lane, that's a tough shot. Rhyming no. Rebound comes to Anderson. Anderson dribbling in front court. Gets it out to Sproul. Hit that three, buddy. Way long. And a battle for the rebound. Comes out to Estevig. Anderson's got it again. Sproul's got it again. Here's Sproul. All the way, buddy. Got it tipped away. Hutcherson's got it, and he throws it away. Here comes Parker as they cross center court. Settling for a lot of three-pointers.
Parker really hasn't been able to get it down inside on the Vikings all tonight.
No, settling for a lot of threes. Oh, might have traveled, no call. Goes up strong, and Anderson's got it. Hobson, Anderson wide open for three. That looks good. It is. 29-9, Stoughton. 4 minutes left in the first half. All right, Stoughton in the front court now. Anderson's got it. All the way. Rimming no, and Janesville's got it.
3:23 left. Stoughton leading 29-9.
Just inside the three-point line. No good. Another long three for Parker. Again, no good. Anderson's got it in the front court. Kicks it out to Hobson. He's going to take it. Just to Evington. Missed the layup.
He didn't have the finish.
That's a foul.
I think number 10, Maurice Sproul, is going to take the charge here.
2:45 left, first half. Janesville down by 20. Good defense all the way in. Layup is good. 29-11.
Good move by Kamar.
Stoughton. Here's McGee back in the game, all the way in there. Off the glass, it's good.
Kale's back in the game, back to scoring points.
Yes. The lead is back to 20. 2:12 left, first half. Here's a little mid-range shot, rimming no. Nelson, rebound. McGee's got it in the front court. Kicks it out. Little runner, dish off to Nelson. And he traveled, yep. Turnover, Stoughton. Apparently that's not the call. We got a foul.
Jack Nelson to the line.
That is Janesville's ninth foul. So it'll be a 1-1.
Give me like 1 minute.
Got this audio figured out.
Leads is 22 now. 1:45. We'll finish out the half and then we'll kind of introduce ourselves and let you know what's going on here.
Live on 981 WSTO.
Just inside the three ball. Back iron no good. That's an over the back call there. Noah Mayhew. Well, Jay, it's good to have you on the air.
Thanks, buddy. It's good to be here.
I've been on for a few minutes.
How you been doing?
It's all right. Stoughton's playing well.
They're in control.
Yep.
Up by 22.
Bonus free throw. First one's good. Yeah, Stoughton's been in control since the beginning.
Drew Anderson and Cale McGee have been having some lights out performances tonight.
Next free throw is short, and Sproul's got it. Here is McGee. He's going all the way. I think he might have tried. Oh, they're going to call a charge on that one.
A little questionable.
I thought he might have traveled there.
Parker's staying in the game, though. They're trying to find a way to score points.
It's tough. They've been launching a lot of threes, and they haven't been hitting them. Here's another one way up there. No good. Back iron, no good. Rebound is back to Parker. It's a strong move to the hole. Missed it again. Nelson's got it. And it's tipped out of bounds, and it'll stay with Parker.
Nelson's a big force down low. He's got to get his hands on that rebound.
And I'm understanding where there's a little static, but we're working on that too.
You want to start static? We don't want that. We don't want the static.
Janesville's cut it to 19, under a minute to play first half. Here's McGee all the way to the hoop. He scores again.
He's been dominant.
Do we know how many points he has?
You know, I lost track, Jay.
He's got to have about 19 already.
He's approaching 20 points, I'm certain of that.
Stoughton by 21. Under 30 seconds left, first half. Here's Parker, they're gonna launch another three. Way off the glass, no good, but the rebound is good. And it's 35-16. Hobson rushing it up court, I'm sure they'll play for one.
About 15 seconds left.
Should play for one anyway. Hobson way out high, 8 seconds left. 6 seconds. Wide open, Mayhew, rimming no. Fire it up there, McGee. Counts if it goes. It's good. And
they're going to wave it off there, Jay.
Is that after the buzzer?
I think it was. I think that's it.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Here we are at halftime, Jay.
Well, let's score is Stoughton 35, Janesville Parker 16. Stoughton's been in control pretty much from the beginning.
I agree, Jay. I don't think this is going to be much of a contest tonight. I tell you what, though. I was looking at Brady Shipper's numbers from last year. He scored 344 points, and I was wondering myself, who could possibly replace him? But I tell you what, this Cale McGee guy looks like a good candidate.
Yeah, and he's only a sophomore. He did play all of last season on the freshman team, but he didn't play a ton of minutes, but he's definitely a starter and a scoring machine, it looks like, here in the first game.
Wow, he's a sophomore.
Yeah, he is. They only start one, you know, Jay, they only start one senior, so they're not going to lose much next year.
No, they're really not going to.
The only senior they... The only senior they're losing is going to be Derek Anderson.
That's Drew Anderson right there.
Did I say Derek?
I don't know what you said.
I meant Drew.
It wasn't Drew. They lost his brother, Tyler Anderson, last year.
They did.
I see his dad, Bane, in the stands. I also see his brother, Tyler. He must be back from college.
No, he's right there, man. Right across the way.
Hanging out with Brock Wanager and Alex Tomchuk.
And is that Piner over there, too?
Oh, I didn't notice that.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's old Joey Lapine.
He's going to Iowa State, Cyclone.
Yeah. So this is the first broadcast of the season for Stoughton Varsity Basketball.
I'm Jason. This is my partner here, Jason. We're Jason and Jason. You can follow us on Twitter at Jason_N_Jason.
Well, do we have any followers yet?
We do. We have one. I'd like to shout out to our follower, Emma Kissling. She had a great game last on
Girls
Tuesday.
Game, yes.
Was that Tuesday? No, that was Friday night.
Friday night. What was the score of that game, Jay?
The final score of that game, that's a good question, Jay.
Now, wasn't it...
It was 43-30. That was a Vikings win.
I think they played Baraboo.
You know, Emma Kissling, she was in foul trouble a lot of the night, but she scored 6 points and she came in late, provided the spark to be needed to win that game.
Yeah.
Good job, Emma. You know, who else had a good game on Friday night was Delaney Seidel. She had 8 points, and Peyton Treloff, she had 11.
Yeah, the Stoughton team is looking good. The girls team is looking good. They, I think they had beaten Verona earlier in the week.
That's a D1 team, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, that's a good sign. Yeah, that girls team, they mean business. Ashley Nelson had 11 rebounds in the middle.
Nice.
That was a good game.
So, yeah, this is, we're Jason and Jason, and we're going to be covering Stoughton basketball, girls and boys, this year. Had some audio issues in the first half, and those seemed to be squared away.
Thank goodness for that.
Yeah, we were all excited, and then we had no microphones.
Getting the jitters there. I had to get on the air and calm myself down.
Are you calm now?
I am.
Okay, good, because I was getting a little worked up, too.
You know, Janesville Parker was 2-21 last year.
That's not very good.
It's not a great record. But I'm sure they're trying to get their program going, and they are fighting hard tonight.
Yeah. You always like to see a team play hard.
You do. You do.
But, you know, this game, I mean, Stoughton got out to a big lead, and I think Cale McGee scored the first 11 points. And did he have a dunk? Is that right?
You know, I think, he was spoiled by a hard foul.
So I think there will be some dunks from McGee this year.
Oh, there's no question about that. Stoughton was 16-9 last year. Varsity boys made it all the way to the sectional semis.
Nice.
How was that game with you?
I think, yeah. 4-9-6. So the boys team's had quite a bit of success the last few years.
I mean, that's kind of putting it mildly. They have 6 consecutive conference championships.
Wow.
Dating all the way back to 2012.
That's pretty good.
Wow. Some big shoes to fill, too. We talked a little bit about Cale McGee maybe stepping in and replacing Shipper. You know, Drew Anderson has got a good shot at filling in for Max Fernholz here. We lost him as a senior. He was our guy up top shooting the three.
Yep.
I think Drew is something like 2 for 3, maybe 2 for 4 tonight. He's got at least 6 points from three.
Yep. And you got Adam Hobson, who is a junior, but he started as a sophomore last year. So he's back. Trenton Conklin's back. And Jack Nelson, who did play some varsity, is back. And I'm just going to say Jack Nelson's just he's a big man down there.
Is he, 6'7"?
Yeah, and we should try to get the ball down to him. And maybe he can dunk it. That would be good.
I would like to see Jack. I would like to see at least one dunk tonight.
I would like to see 3 dunks a game from Stoughton.
It's a good goal.
I mean, because you're going to get one from Kale at least, maybe 2. And then maybe Reese Sproul could dunk one, I think, right?
Sure. Adam Hobson could get
up
there.
So we got at least 3 dunks a game.
Well, we haven't had any yet tonight, so it's going to have to be 3 in the second half.
Okay, that's all right.
We'll take it.
We'll get at least 1 on a nice breakaway. So earlier tonight, the JV team handled Parker quite easily. Did we write down that score?
I didn't write down that score.
I think they won by about 25, though.
Something like that.
Somewhere in the 55 to 30 range. We'll try to keep tabs on the JV game. Looks like they got some young promising players as well. So.
You know, they also got to replace, the Vikings got to replace Tommy McLean from last year. He led the team in rebounds with 112. I know Jack's had a few tonight. He's lost a handle on a couple. But he's got the capability of stepping in and grabbing those rebounds for us this year, no doubt.
Yep.
Jay, about 3 years ago, they changed from quarters to halves. What does that do to the game, anything?
Well, I think it speeds up the game a little bit. They play 2 18-minute halves. They used to, the college plays 2 20-minute halves. And
we got Mel Dow, the athletic director, up here talking to us. He's live on the air with us. You bet.
We're good.
That's Mel Dow, the athletic director. He really does a great job here at Stoughton High School. Did you know, Jay, 60% of students here at Stoughton High School participate in an extracurricular activity?
Oh, yeah. I did not know that. So what kind of other activities would there be? I mean, you have all kinds, you have the sports, but you also have a lot of other things.
I suppose you got, chess club.
Norwegian dancers, that's one.
Norwegian dancers.
Yeah.
You might have, the physics club, maybe, something like that.
I wouldn't know, but I'm assuming they have one, yeah. So, a couple minutes left here at halftime.
You got to be good to wear different color shoes like that. Purple shoes on Kale McGee. It's making a statement. He sure has lived up to the shoes tonight.
Yes.
Here come the coaches. That's Kurt Bale and head coach Noah Weber. Parker's back on the floor, too.
So, for Parker to have any chance in this game, what do you think they got to do here in the first few minutes of the second half?
Well, they got big problems because they're going to have to try and figure out a way to slow down Kale McGee slicing and dicing, and that just opens everything up. We got Drew Anderson on the perimeter. We got, like you said, Adam Hobson, and big Jack Nelson down low. They're just going to have to play good defense, and they're going to have to score from the perimeter when they get those chances. They just missed a bunch of those tonight.
They've taken a ton of threes, and I don't know if they've made any, maybe one. And this would be a fairly close game if they just had hit some of their shots.
It's true.
They haven't hit any shots. They're launching, though.
Hey, you can't score if you don't shoot it.
That's right. Keep shooting, man.
And
So I'm assuming Stoughton will come out with their five starters, which would be Cale McGee, Drew Anderson, Adam Hobson, and who am I forgetting there? Jack Nelson.
Nathan Hutcherson.
Nathan Hutcherson, yes. Has Hutcherson scored today?
Well, he's had his hands on the ball a couple times. I don't know if he's put one in yet, though.
You know, with a comfortable lead, you really like, you know, on Stoughton's end, you like to see some ball movement, get some other people some looks. You know what I mean?
Yep.
But I'll tell you what, you give the ball to McGee and they're not gonna stop him.
Doesn't look like it.
Parker will start with the ball in the second half. Going from right to left here. Mid-range jumper, brick no. And that's Anderson with the rebound. Nice pass. Finish that, Nelson. Oh.
That's the way to do it, though, Jay. Get it down low to big Jack Nelson. He can't stop that.
Nope. Two shots for Nelson. Excellent look there by Anderson.
That was a good pass.
First free throw was good. So, yeah, they do have the five starters out there. Second free throw was also good.
Stoughton leads 37-16, 17-40 left on the clock in the second half.
Dane Parker here in the front court. It's a nice move. Nice dish. Long three-pointer is rimming no. McGee with the rebound.
Parker just missed another three-point shot.
Yep. Oh. There's McGee with the ball. All the way, layup is, rolls in there. Wow.
That was Cale McGee versus Janesville Parker, and Cale McGee won.
Yeah. He said, I'm taking it to the hole, and he put it in. There's Parker now in the front court. Looks, they gotta call a travel there, don't they?
No, they're gonna call a jump off. Mm. Possession arrow to us. We'll take it. Turnover. Janesville Parker. 16:49 left. Stoughton leads 39-16. Hutcherson to McGee to Anderson.
McGee for three. Off the glass, no good. That's another offensive foul.
That's his second charge tonight. That one was obvious.
Yep, push off. Second foul on McGee.
That is the second foul.
Parker with the ball. You might have to help me with the Janesville team there. That's a three ball. Finally good. Cut it to 20.
Is that 14, Brady Biba?
Here's Hutcherson. Dishes it off to Hobson all the way in there. No good. Missed everything on that one.
Good drive, just missed.
Oh, thrown away.
Mishandled there by 14. Brady Biba. 15:51 left. Vikings lead 39-19. Second half.
Here's Hutcherson in the front court to McGee. Wild shot, no good. Nelson's got it. Backs it in there, off the glass, good.
Boy,
strong rebound.
Boy, when Jack Nelson goes up strong like that, it's hard to imagine someone rejecting him. It's a big component of our offense. And defense.
Yeah, that's Curry, number 30. He's pretty good.
Yeah, he is good.
Ball seems to be in his hands most of the time.
Yeah, he's helped create most of their points, for sure.
Stoughton up by 21, or I should say 22. Good defense, Stoughton.
Parker still struggling to get it down low on Stoughton.
That's a foul.
They're going to call that on number five, Adam Hobson.
They might have called that on Anderson. Nope, you're right, number four.
Nope, you were right, number four. That's.
Oh, it is Anderson.
That's Drew Anderson, yeah.
Two shots for Parker. And the first one is Remy No.
That's number 32, Matthew Hartwig at the line.
Looks like he's only a sophomore. Second one rims in.
14:47 left. Stoughton leads 41-20.
Still have the starting five out there for Stoughton. There's McGee. Goes up strong. Good. You're just not going to stop him. I mean, here's Curry. Nice move to the hole.
Wow.
And it's good.
It's a great shot by number 30.
That's Curry.
That's Curry.
Hutcherson off the glass, no good. Another rebound by Nelson. Another putback, no good. Look at him get those rebounds, huh? He's battling.
I like it.
What are they going to call there, an offensive foul?
Jack Nelson's got to step up and fill McLean's shoes, and he's doing a good job tonight.
Yeah. Here's Curry again, all the way to the hole. No good. Now Stoughton's running. Anderson's got it.
Anderson got that rebound.
Over to Hobson. Hobson dishes it to Nelson. Nelson going, nope, and a call's on the floor. Foul's on 12. DeLong. Nelson misses the layup. Wanted the foul, but you got to just finish that one strong. Curry, no good.
Ooh, thought he might have got hacked in the lane.
Yeah, he got hit in the face. Long three. Dunk that. Oh. Thought that might be a dunk attempt, dunk opportunity.
Nelson in the right place at the right time. Yep. 13:30 left. Stoughton leads 45-22 in the second half.
Stoughton with the ball. There's, oh, McGee's got a breakaway. This could be the dunk, Shafe. Oh!
Yes,
oh, he gets a technical. You see that? And they're going to call a technical foul on that one. He hung on the rim.
Does he get the points?
Do we get the points? So he's going to.
He's going to get a technical foul for killing it?
Well, I mean, in the NBA, that's okay.
I don't know why he's okay in high school. What did he do wrong?
Well, he dunked it, and then he hung in hung out for a while on the rim. And apparently that's not cool.
What's the expectation?
No.
I don't get it.
And now, after dunking it, he's coming out.
He's going to see the pine here for that, and could see head coach Noah Weber give him a little bit of an earful. 13-17 left in the second half. Stoughton leads 47-22. They did give him the points.
Yeah, I like the dunk. And then he just hung there a little too long, you know.
That's silly.
You don't like that call?
I don't.
But you can't do that in high school. You can't hang on it, you know.
Well, what if he was doing it to protect himself and other players?
You know, that's a good point. I don't know if he was or not.
What's the expectation? Take a fall flat on your back? And it doesn't make
Yeah,
sense.
Well, he's out of the game. I think that's, who's in there? Conklin's in there, number 13.
Yeah, but number 15.
Three ball for Janesville. Missed everything on that one. Here comes Anderson. And he dribbled it out of bounds.
Just a mishandle. Good thought. We got Trevor Conklin and Noah Mayhew in here.
Yep. Oh, here's Conklin with the ball in the open court. Gives it to Anderson. All the way. And out of bounds.
That was a clean block by Janesville Parker at number 30.
He's I think he's shaking up a little bit there, Jay.
Mark Curry really is a good player.
He's been all over the place tonight. Not a bad student crowd tonight over there.
Student crowd's hopping. You know, it's Thanksgiving week. Jay, happy Thanksgiving to you.
Yeah, you too. I got to work tomorrow, but the kids are done, right?
Yep.
Hutcherson for three. Yes.
Got it.
It good.
12:43 left in the second half. Stoughton leads 50-23.
The lead has ballooned to 27. Now you're gonna think about getting some other guys in there, don't you think?
Well, now if you're Janesville Parker, you just gotta start launching threes.
Yeah.
You can't take too much time either.
Doesn't seem like they've subbed a lot. Really? Long three by Curry, rimming no. Oh, there's a long one to Hutcherson. And, foul.
Took a foul by number 30, Shamar Curry.
I think Curry might be taking himself out of the game. Is that what's happening?
I mean, it looks like it.
Oh, he's just going to talk to the coach.
He's trying to tell him he can't do it alone.
Hutcherson, first free throw is short, and Curry is out of the game. In is number 10, Brody Dahlke. Dahlke? No,
number 10 is Reese Sproul.
Oh, yeah, for Janesville.
Oh.
But yeah, Sproul's in for Stoughton. He's a sophomore. What do they list Sproul at? Second free throw's no good.
I think 6'4".
They list him at 6'5". It's got a little bit of height on Stoughton. But that's a travel, isn't it? No good. That's a foul. And that's going to be on Mayhew. Is that how? Noah Mayhew? Mayhew?
It's Mayhew.
Mayhew, okay.
Yeah. Well, it's Thanksgiving week, and I see a lot of the graduated seniors here in the crowd. It's good to see that kind of school spirit.
First free throw is good. 50-24, Vikings. Second one is rimming no. Battle for the rebound comes to Stoughton. And a foul. That's going to be on number 11, Brody Lippins. You know what's interesting, Shafe, is Janesville Parker has two kids named Brody. And they also have a kid named Brady.
They also have two Thompsons, AJ and Ethan.
That's a three ball. That's good. And now the route is on now. It's up by 29. Stone's up by 29. And a foul. That's going to be on Conklin, number 13. What do they have two of?
Two Thompsons. The Thompson twins, Jay. Remember that group from the 80s?
So on the line here is first free throw is way off. It's Brendan Weiss. And
Hobson's in for Hutcherson.
You got to think Stoughton would start putting in some of the other players here. The second one's good.
No, there's still 11:36 in the first half. Maybe just give it a little bit.
That's the second. Oh. Stoughton by 28.
15 Noah Mayhew and 13 Conklin still in the game.
Reese looking to inbound it. Hobson shot. A rimming no. Rebound. And here comes Parker in the front court. Nice move to the hoop, and he couldn't finish. Couldn't finish again. Conklin rebound. Oh, nice pass. Nice idea.
He's looking for Noah Mayhew there.
Yeah. So the game in hand for Stoughton as we approach 11 minutes here in the game. That was a travel, wasn't it? Yeah, travel. I find this a little interesting. They're going to put McGee back in the game.
Well, I don't really understand that move. I mean, I think he's got 52 of the 53 points tonight, doesn't he?
I think he's got 51 out of timeout on the floor. And, you know, as we look in the crowd here, I mean, look at more Stoughton kids coming in. Isn't that Tommy McLean right there?
That's Tommy McLean. We were just talking about Jack Nelson having to fill those shoes. There he is.
I guess there wasn't a timeout.
He's in the game for 2 seconds. He's back at the line.
Yeah. I think McGee's got about 40. Rimming no. So how many games are we going to be doing this year, Shake?
I don't know, Jay. I think it's up to like 20-something, 20-plus, right?
Yeah. And, you know, we got to we'll work out some of the kinks here with the audio, and we'll get it situated.
Yeah, you know, I mean, maybe getting on the air before the game starts is, you know, probably a good goal.
That would be awesome. Yeah. That would be. That's my goal for the next game is to get on the air, like, before, you know, like, actually before the game starts.
That'd be good. Here on 981 WSTO.
Now, if you don't have, say you don't have Charter, okay. Now how else could you watch the game?
Well, you could stream live at WSTO.tv.
Yeah, and when you go on that site, you can click the live. Here's McGee scoring again.
Straight down the center of the key, almost uncontested. No one can stop him.
I mean, who's going to stop him? There's a floater, no good. Sproul with the rebound. Here comes Hobson. McGee, it's probably going up. Yep. No good. Conklin, go up strong, buddy. And one. There you go. Good job.
That is a great job by Conklin there.
You know, I think we're going to start seeing some.
Yeah, checking in is number 24.
And let's see, number 20.
Ethan Scablin. And number
Owen
20.
Chase, a junior, checks into the game for the first time. Full timeout on the floor.
9:45 left in the ball game. Stoughton leading 58-25.
Looks like it might be some kind of blackout over there in the student section, isn't it?
Yeah, they're all wearing black in the student section. That's Stoughton, yeah. Student section. I don't know what that's about.
A lot of kids back from college. A lot of them probably the first time they've come back. Wouldn't you say?
I would say.
Get some good home cooking from mom. You know.
How can you beat that?
So I believe the next broadcast will be, we're going to be doing some back-to-back action on the 29th and 30th.
Is that a Friday and a Saturday?
Yeah, I think one girls, one boys.
Perfect. Well, you're enjoying the broadcast tonight. Again, this is Jason and Jason. You can follow us on Twitter at Jason_N_Jason.
You know, I don't know if I've ever tweeted before, but I might start.
Well, we've tweeted together. Jason.
Yeah, we have, yeah.
But no, I don't have my own personal account. Okay. Just the broadcaster account.
Well, we'll get some. I mean, it's probably going to grow real quick.
No, I mean,
I would think.
I expect at least 100,000 followers at the end of the year. I don't know. You gotta set the bar high.
Free throw's no good. Man, they're still. That's a good move to the hole there.
That was a good move. We're not giving up. That was number 25.
Janesville playing hard here.
Brandon Weiss. Or is it Weiss?
McGee again. That looks. Ooh, that's a travel.
Ooh. All right, settle down there. Settle down.
So, you know, it looks like. The boys and girls team, I think we're going to have a pretty fun season. What do you think?
It's getting off to a great start. No losses. Girls are 2-0. Boys look to go 1-0 here tonight.
Yep. It's a nice pass. Just, I think, a foot on the line there. Rimming no. And a nice follow by Curry.
Yeah,
he's playing really hard.
More points for him. Conklin's done a real good night, real good job spelling Jack Nelson tonight.
Yep. Go up strong, buddy. No good. That's Ethan Scablin. Played a little bit in the first half. Courier with the three. Rimming no. And here comes McGee and Stoughton. Lazy pass there.
Stolen by Curry. Who else?
Nice move. That's just a good move.
8:23 left in the second half. Stoughton leading 58-31.
Ball knocked out of bounds.
Kale with a good drive to the basket.
Looks like Anderson and Hutcherson checking back in, spelling Hobson and McGee. I'd be surprised if either one of those play again tonight.
I would be too. 8:18 left in the ball game. Stoughton leads 58-31.
Nice pass. Go up strong there, buddy. Anderson. Just a nice save. Good hustle. Anderson's got it.
It's trapped. Got it out to Hutcherson.
8 minutes left. Scablin to Hutcherson. Hutcherson, nice pass. Go up strong, buddy. There you go. Good finish by Scablin. Yep. Good job, buddy.
Way to contribute tonight. Get
He's a 6'4" junior. That's just inside the three-point line. Back iron, no good. A rebound, Anderson. Stops and pops for three. Rimming, no. Here comes Janesville. Nice move.
Wow. Where's that been all night for Janesville Parker? Number 11, Brody Lippins with an excellent move.
Oh, just... Tell you what, James was playing hard. Missed a layup. Here comes Stoughton. 7 minutes left. Stoughton by 27. Here's Anderson. And a foul. And his number 20, Owen Chase, got fouled. Team foul, so Stoughton will be in the 1-1. Checking in is Reese Sproul.
Checking out is number 13, Trenton Conklin. He had some real good minutes tonight.
Yep, played hard. I think this will be a 1-1. Free throw is good. I think that's his first point.
I agree.
Chase's first point. A 5'11 junior.
Good to see Scablin and Chase get some points here tonight.
Yep.
Some important minutes, too. And Jack Nelson's been able to spend a lot of time on the bench because Trevor Conklin's played so well.
Second free throw is rimming no, and Parker with the rebound. Nice pass, and a nice finish. That is number 32.
Matthew Hartwig.
Looks like he's only a sophomore. And a timeout by Stoughton.
6:30 left in the second half. Stoughton up 61-35.
And at this point in the game, this is pretty much a substitution timeout.
Is this what they call garbage time, Jay?
I think we're in garbage time now. So now we're gonna get some other players in the game here.
That's about what I expected.
Yep, and we'll let you know everyone who's in there. And some of the kids that are going to be playing right now have not played yet tonight. And you know, some of these kids that are going to get the opportunity to play right now, they don't necessarily get to play a lot.
That's great. Looks like we got number 3, Zach Burke. In the game.
A 5'9 senior has checked in.
It'll be his first minutes of the game.
Yep. I think he needs to launch a three. What do you think?
Get it way too up.
Yep.
Put it up, kid.
Shoot that, Sproul. Nope. There's Chase. Over to... There you go. Finish it strong, bud. Got fouled. There you go.
Pain gets to the line.
Zach Burke will go to the line and shoot two. He's listed at 5'9". Do we think he's 5'9"?
I mean, I can't really see. We're pretty high up in the stands.
First free throw is good, and he's on the board. Burke has scored, and it's, I don't know, is that 27 now? 27-point lead. Second free throw is no good. Tipped around a little bit, and Parker's got it.
Sproul tried to steal it there, just couldn't get it.
There's Curry again. And knocked out of bounds there.
Good D by 24, Scavlin.
So some of these kids that are going to get an opportunity to play like Burke, you know, they practice really hard. And, you know, they might go a few games and not play. But they practice hard and they're part of the team, and it's great to see some of those guys get some playing time.
Yeah, well, I mean, the team needs them. You know, they got to practice against them, and they help the team get better.
Yep. I think this one's in the books for Stoughton. But, you like to see both teams keep playing hard.
Yeah, Janesville Park is not going to quit out of here.
Curry for three. Back iron no good. Oh, that's got to be an over the back. Yep.
Number three, Burke, goes up strong, grabs a rebound, and gets
home. Yep, that's on Robert DeLong, who checks out.
Good performance from Zach Burke here.
Not sure who got fouled there. Is that going to be Burke again?
Yeah, Burke.
I think this one will be the double bonus. First one's good. And Noah Mayhew's back in the game. Is that 2 points for Burke?
It is, 2 points for Burke. Both from the line.
Nice. Rimming, no. So he's 2 for 4 from the line. 5.5 to play. Good defense. Stone still playing tough defense. There's
more,
Curry.
More of a zone here late in the game.
You don't want to foul here late in the game.
It's going to be on two, Nathan Hutcherson.
Parker's not in the bonus yet.
Hutcherson's third foul.
Nice dish off the glass, and it's no good. Rebound's good.
Good rebound by Brady Dubon.
Stone's still pushing it. Look at Burke. There's a three. Oh, no good.
4:55 left in the second half. Stoughton up 63-37.
Has Curry sat out at all this game?
I don't think so.
Jeez.
He's clearly their best player.
Yeah, threw it out of bounds. Just when you say that, he throws it out of bounds. But he's got to be exhausted at this point. Now we're getting some. All right, let's keep an eye on who's coming in. Okay, Shay? So coming in is Graham Scheel.
Number 12.
5'10" senior checks in. So I believe there are no starters on the floor at this point.
Well, I think number 10 there, Reese Sproul, starts, doesn't he?
He does not.
Oh.
I don't think. He did not start this game. Is that Burke at the line again?
It is.
You know, Burke comes into the game and he just starts firing free throws.
Yeah, grabbing rebounds, getting free
getting
throws.
Fouled.
Getting tough.
I think he's got two here. He's 2 for 4. First one is back iron, no good. Looks like there's still a few players on the bench for Stoughton. I'm sure they'll get in the game here. Second free throw is good.
Shooting 50%.
3 for 6. Foul. Parker's now in the bonus.
They're going to call that on. How they're going to call it on number 3, Zach Burke.
He gets fouled and he fouls. That's what he does.
Rebounds too.
Yeah. Bonus free throw is short, and that's tipped out to Burke. Now Burke gets rebounds too. Oh, tough.
Ooh.
And a turnover from Burke. Nice dish.
Wide open.
Yeah.
It's a good play.
Yep.
It's a good 2 points by number 32.
Cuts it to 25.
Matthews.
Stoughton clearly in control here.
Yeah, this game is over.
Burke's like, that guy's all over him.
Oh, yeah, Krabby.
There's Burke. Oh, Burke's in trouble there.
Oh,
nice pass to Sproul. Good.
left in the second half. Stoughton up 66-39.
Three ball from Curry.
In and out.
All the way down and out. Here's Graham Shield. Oh, uh-oh. We might see a dunk here, Schaaf. Oh, we missed the dunk. You know what? You got to go for it there, don't you?
You got to go. You're down big in the ball game. I might want to just get something going.
Good thing you didn't hang on the rim there, though, Schaaf.
Right, that's a technical. Now I know.
I mean, if you could dunk in high school, wouldn't you hang? I would.
I would, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, go up strong, Sproul. Good job.
Sproul, 4 points.
So Sproul, number 10, and McGee are both sophomores, and they're going to be a big, big part of the Stoughton program in the future here.
I tell you what, Jay, I came into the game thinking, boy, we lost a lot of seniors. How are we gonna perform? But I'm pleasantly surprised tonight.
Curry, no good. Sproul again. Looks like Stoughton's going to get their few remaining bench players in the game here.
2:25 left in the second half. Stoughton up 70-39.
Tough shot. Rims in. That kid's been playing good too.
That's Matthew Hartwig.
Really him and Curry. And that's a substitution timeout. So Stoughton will get the remaining bench players in. It looks like Parker's doing the same. Everyone to get a chance to play. I'll tell you what, with Parker, Curry played hard. I mean, I don't even know if he came out.
I'd say let's pick a man of the match today, but I mean, hands down, I think we both know who that's going to be.
Let's see who's been here for Stoughton. Okay, so 22, Lucas Bennett, 5'9 junior, he's in the game. Also number 11, Alex Johnson, a 5'9 junior. And am I missing anyone?
Yeah, you're missing number 23, Tyler Martinson.
Okay, what grade's he in?
Looks like Tyler is a freshman.
Can't be a freshman. Number 23? No, he's a junior. Stoughton has 70 points. Oh, tough pass there.
Trying to get it down low too, Martinson.
Martinson's listed at 6'4". He should be able to dunk, right?
I mean, some people can.
I mean, if you're 6'4", you should be able to put it down.
Well, Jay, I'm 6'3", and I can tell you what I can't do.
You can't dunk?
No.
Hmm.
I bet you heavier than I was in high school.
I bet you he can dunk. If he was wide open, he would dunk. Go up, buddy. Hit that three. Shoot it. Launch it. Looks good, Schaaf. Oh, rimming no. And Parker is running. All the way to the nice move there.
Oh, number 15.
Nice move. Oh, and almost a steal there.
Jaden Collins, his first 2 points of the game.
Now you might not be surprised if Stoughton shoots again. It's a foul. Your man Burke's going to the line again.
50% tonight, 3-for-6.
Pretty good crowd here tonight.
Really is a good crowd.
And is it Thanksgiving Eve Eve?
It is Thanksgiving double Eve. We'll be doing a turkey trot around Stoughton tomorrow night. Everybody's welcome to join us. And a happy Thanksgiving to all the listeners out there listening to us on 921. WSTO.
You want to check the number again on
that? It's 981,
Jay.
921's probably not going to be WSTO.
I mean, you can check on 921, but it probably won't be on there.
You know what? Tweet us and let us know what is on 921.
I'm actually interested. That's not a travel. There it is. Double dribble. Remember the video game Double Dribble?
I do.
That was fun.
It was great. That was on the original Nintendo, wasn't it?
It was, yeah. Graphics probably weren't that great, but.
Under a minute to go here, Jay. Stoughton's going to win. Score's currently 71-43.
I'm not sure what that. There's a three ball. Oh, it's good.
Oh, that's number 11, Alex.
Yeah.
Johnson.
That almost scraped the roof of the building here. That's great.
Good foul on number 23. Tyler Martins and not let him.
I mean, if you don't get an opportunity to play a lot, I mean, you just come in and you launch, right?
Well, yeah, you know, you play
I
tough.
Mean, if you got an open, I mean, if you got any kind of look, you're just gonna fire. Free throws, no good.
Get everything out of your minutes.
Stoughton up, is that 31 we're up by?
It's a lot.
Yeah.
It's too much to overcome in 40 seconds, I can tell you that.
Yeah, it is. Second one rims in, and it's a 30-point game. Oh. So now we need, let's get in there, Martinson. Oh, no good. Now the last 30 seconds of play. Parker looking to cut it to 28. And they do. Now I think you just dribble out the clock.
I mean, there's no need for another shot. Well,
nope.
Like you said, maybe take one more, right?
Well, it depends. But usually, typically here, you just run it out. I mean, he should launch.
Launch at 22.
Oh, shoot it. Nope.
That's a classy thing to do.
That's it.
That's a ball game, Jay.
That is the ball game.
74-46. They're 1-0 on the season.
A impressive victory. Seemed a fairly easy win for Stoughton.
It was a fairly easy win, but I can tell you, if I had to choose my man of the match, hands down,
Cale McGee. Yeah.
This kid's tough.
Well, he did score like 60, right?
Yeah, I mean, I think he had 72 of the 74 points.
Yeah,
like
it's probably more around 58, but.
Yeah.
But I tell you what, he takes it to the hole, and you're just, you know, you're not going to stop him. You're just not going to stop him.
He obviously takes the game seriously.
Well, in a game like this, everyone from Stoughton got in the game. Most of the kids scored. You know, I was really impressed with McGee, though. I mean, I know he's a good player, but geez.
I mean, you know, I talked to his father, Jason McGee, a couple weeks ago, and you know how dads are.
He ain't that good, right?
That's yeah, what he's you know, like, yeah.
He knows he's good, right?
Yeah, and then
he doesn't want to be that like that, though, right?
Wow. Kid's good.
Yeah, he's really good.
Well, I'm really excited about this Stoughton Vikings basketball season for the boys and for the girls. It's really going to be a good season. I see him winning a lot of games.
I do too.
Well, so, I guess we'll sign off here, Jay. What do you think?
Well, our final score tonight again.
74-46, Stoughton Viking victory.
Over the, do you know? I think the Park Janesville Parker is also the Vikings.
Jay, is there a place where, are they also the Vikings?
So the Vikings beat the Vikings tonight.
All right. Well, it's a Viking victory any way you slice it. Is there anywhere people head to after the games? Typically on the weekends, but I think they all go out to Culver's, maybe have a frozen custard.
Yeah, or maybe you could have, like, the flavor of the day.
Oh.
You know, you could do that.
Well, that sounds good.
You know. Yeah, that's always a good option.
I think a lot of the kids go up there post-game. That's a good thing to do. It's just real good team spirit around here. Well, again, this has been Jason and Jason announcing Stoughton basketball for you tonight. Again, follow us on Twitter at Jason_N_Jason.
This broadcast of Stoughton High School boys basketball on WSTO-TV is brought to you by Stoughton Hospital. For more than 100 years, our neighbors in the Stoughton area have trusted Stoughton Hospital to provide personalized, forward-thinking, expert healthcare. Stoughton Hospital is a proud supporter of WSTO programming, trusted care close to home. Stoughton Trailers is proud to support Stoughton High School Athletics. Come join the family. Apply now on our career page at stoughtontrailers.com. The UPS Store of Stoughton. You can't do it all at once, but you can do it all in one place. 2364 Jackson Street, next to Papa Murphy's. Hanson Electronics, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent and Radio Shack dealer. Pizza Pit of Stoughton, fresh, fast, and hot delivery of our great pizzas, sandwiches, chicken, and more. And McGlynn Pharmacy, your local full-service pharmacy with free delivery.